here in Kyoto today, and today's video is going to be about shooting RAW. I've got three cameras. There are currently three right now, point and shoot cameras that shoot RAW 360 photos. So I thought I'd take them for a spin at three amazing locations around Kyoto and see what kinds of results we can get in mixed lighting situations. Hey, check out this place. How cool is this? 360 degree views. So I think this is the perfect place to shoot our first 360. Oh, look who it is. It's Yost. And you may have seen this guy on Instagram, exploring 360.
That's me.
So without further ado, let's go shoot some RAW photos.
Wait just a minute. I should probably explain what RAW actually is for those of you who don't understand the difference between RAW and JPEG. When you shoot JPEG, you're essentially shooting an image with all the colors, contrast, and whatnot baked into the image, which makes it harder to color correct and recover detail from shadows and highlights. With RAW, it captures a lot more information about your scene, making it easier to color correct later on. So if your shadows turn to black, you can then recover them and make them properly exposed. If your highlights are turned to white, same thing, you can recover those highlights. At the end of the day, this means your exposure is going to be almost perfect, which is why it's a really good idea to shoot RAW if your camera allows it. I'm back in my Airbnb now, and real quick, I want to show you how I process my RAW files. Firstly, how I stitch them, and then how I color correct them. We're going to do them one by one. So first off, let's do the Fusion. So the workflow for the Fusion is color correct first, stitch second. So as you can see, I've copied my files over from my two SD cards into a folder on my laptop. And these all look the same, right? But if you look really closely, you'll see the first two are GPBK, the second two are GPFR. This means front and back. So what I'm going to do is select both of the GPR files, which are front and back, and I'm going to drag them simultaneously into Photoshop. And in Photoshop, I edit in Adobe Camera Raw. That's the extension for Photoshop that allows you to get a lot of control over your RAW files. And as you can see on the left, it's imported both of them, and we want to edit these at the same time, so the exact same color adjustments apply to both images at once. So I'll press Shift and select both of them. And when I do a massive change like that, you can see on the left, they both change accordingly. Now it's up to you to make your color adjustments over here. You can also do this in Lightroom, just follow the same process and make sure you're color correcting both files at once. When you're done, go open images, and we want to save these as JPEGs, and we now want to save these to the same folder as before. However, having the exact file name is going to be super important for this step, so make sure you pay close attention. What you'll need to do is add an underscore GPR in capitals to your file. Yes, it's a JPEG, but we're saving it as underscore GPR.JPEG for both our front and back photos. Then we're going to make sure we have as much resolution as possible and go OK. So here we have our folder. You should have six files in it. Even though this is only going to turn into one photo, we have our GoPro RAW files from before. We have our JPEGs that were already there. It's important that you don't delete those. And we have our new JPEGs of our edited photos. Now we're going to open up Fusion Studio and go File, Open RAW Photos. Hey, the workflow is written here in case you forget anything, or if something's not quite working, refer to this and it'll show you exactly what to do. Now hit Got It and navigate to the photo folder and go Open. There we go, Fusion Studio has found our RAW file, and now we can edit it and we
can add that to the render queue and export as we normally would a photo.
Next, I'm gonna stitch my Insta360 One RAW files, and this is really easy. I've put the micro SD card into a card reader, and it's really as simple as dragging the DNG files into Insta360 Studio. So when you choose the RAW option on the camera, it records both INSP files and DNG. So this is essentially JPEG and RAW, and we're going to drag our DNGs into Insta360 Studio, which is free. So let's go ahead and drag it in. At the top left, you can see it's confirmed that it's a RAW file. So now we're gonna go ahead and export to our desktop. Simple as that. Next, let's stitch Mesphere RAW files. And, I gotta go catch a flight. This is awkward. So with the Mesphere, there's two different workflows for Mac and PC, whereas the other two cameras have the exact same workflow. So if you're on PC, you want to download the free Mesphere software, I'll link it down there, and that will stitch your raw DNGs in about a minute or so. If you're on Mac, it's not so easy, but it's easy-ish. So I'm gonna show you how to do it right here, right now, before I board my flight. So there's a sneaky little program you can download called MadV Picture Stitch, and it's not a program so much as it is a file structure. So I've got it here on my desktop, and I will include the download link in the description if you're on Mac, so check that out. So essentially all you need to do is open it up and navigate to the original folder. Now we're going to go to our SD card drive, and you'll see JPEGs and DNGs in that folder. Drag the DNG from your memory card into the original folder. Next, we're going to open up the file that says MadV Picture Stitch, and this is what's going to begin the stitching of our DNG file. And this is what's going to begin the stitching of our DNG file. So now all we need to do is double click MadV Picture Stitch, and everything in the original folder is now going to be stitched and put into the stitched folder. So now that we've stitched photos from all three cameras, how do we edit them? Well, it's a very good question, and it's something that is going to totally transform your images from flat and boring into colorful, vibrant, and amazing. But I'm about to board my flight from Osaka to Tokyo, so I gotta run, so give me a few seconds. Okay, so here's how I color correct. And look, there are many color correction tutorials out there, so I'm gonna keep this brief, but I just wanna show you guys real quick what you can do when you color correct a RAW file and how much latitude you have to really enhance your colors and fixed underexposed or overexposed images. So here's my Insta360 One DNG file that I brought into Adobe Camera Raw. And straight away, the first place I go is the shadows and the highlights. Firstly, I'm going to bring the shadows right up. And already, I can see a much better exposed image. Now, highlights, they're gonna go down, you know it. And look at that, look at the clarity of those clouds before, after. You don't wanna overdo it, but you do wanna bring back as much detail as you can. Next, I'm gonna go for the vibrance and bring that up. And the difference between vibrance and saturation is with vibrance, it takes into account skin tones and it doesn't oversaturate your skin. Whereas if you boost the saturation, it's gonna make you several shades darker. So I'm only going to boost the saturation a little bit, but I will bring the vibrance up quite a bit so we can really bring those greens to life. I'm gonna go up with my exposure a little bit too, because I still feel like it's a little bit dark. And I might even go a little bit higher on the shadows to really bring out the details in those trees and in the water. Now there's a little magical button down here that will show you the before and after. This is before, that's after. How incredible does that look? I honestly can't believe my eyes that this raw DNG file from the Insta360 One has totally transformed this image and made this something I'd be super proud to publish anywhere. This, my friends, is the power of shooting raw. While I did expose this image pretty well, some cameras just don't do the best job at exposing, which is where raw will have your back. There are actually lots of apps you can edit your RAW files in. The Adobe Suite are my favorite. I like using Photoshop and Lightroom. They're both excellent, but there are free ones as well. You can use just basic color correction inside of the free photo apps for both Mac and PC. There are many different workflows for both stitching and editing RAW photos. This was mine. If you have a different one, leave it in the comments below. I'd be very interested to hear it, but it's actually surprisingly easy and you can get an excellent result with a very cheap point and shoot 360 camera that shoots RAW. And on that note, I've got a flight to catch, so hit that subscribe button if you're not subscribed already. Follow me on Instagram here and Facebook there, and I will see you in the next video. See what I did there? Yeah, I'm getting pretty good at this whole editing thing. Took me long enough. Okay, bye.